Praise the Lord, saints.
Praise the Lord.
For God is worthy. Savior,
yes.
And the Holy Ghost,
yes,
sir. Our Comforter,
thank you.
Our Guide,
yes, Lord.
To this fine pastor,
yes, Lord.
Angel of this church,
yes.
Pastor Evans,
yes.
To the ministerial staff here at Shiloh,
yes, Lord.
To Pastor Stalwart, to others who may be in our congregation, we recognize you. To the officers of this church and visiting officers, to my wife, to my family, amen. Sister Diane Richards, Sister Hannah Wiley, my first cousins. Good to see Brother Weldon and his wife back tonight with the Greens. Thank God for each and every one of you. And to this pastor, y'all just excuse me for a few minutes. Have really blessed me and reminded me how good God is. For this privilege just to be one of his servants.
Amen.
So we're not going to hold you long tonight, but the Spirit of the Lord says so. I didn't realize last night that it was as long as it was. I guess when you're having fun, you lose track of time. I enjoy. His word.
Yes.
Amen. It seems like sometimes the older I get, the longer I'm up. And sometimes the only thing God gives me is just a little. But he has a lot to say. So tonight we're going to go to very familiar passage of scripture. You've heard it preached so many times, and I said to you on last night, I don't have anything new. It may be fresh, but it's not new, because there is nothing, the Bible says there's nothing new under the sun. And so turn with us to the book of Isaiah chapter 6. Book of Isaiah, chapter 6. Isaiah chapter 6. If you have it, say amen.
Amen.
If you're still looking for it, say wait. We're just going to look at the first 8 verses of this great chapter. And as we get ready to look at it, the chapters before, Isaiah had a lot to say about the people of God. Even issued a lot of woes. But we hear a different tone when we arrive here in chapter 6. He begins, he says, in the year that King Uzziah died, I saw also the Lord. And I saw him sitting upon a throne, high and lifted up. And his train filled the temple. Above it stood the seraphims.
Yes, Lord.
Each one had 6 wings.
Right.
With 20 he covered his face.
Yes.
And with 20 he covered his feet.
Yes, Lord.
And with 20 he did fly.
Mm-hmm.
And one cried unto another and said, holy, holy, holy,
holy
is the Lord of. The whole earth is full of his glory. And the post of the door moved at the voice of him that cried. The house was filled with smoke. Then I said, woe is me, for I am undone. Because I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips. For mine eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. Then flew one of the seraphims unto me, having a live coal in his hand, which he had taken from the tongs from off the altar. And he laid it upon my mouth and said, lo, this hath touched thy lips, and thine iniquity is taken away, and thy sin is purged. Also I heard the voice of the Lord saying, whom shall I send, and who will go for us? Then said I, here am I, send me. This is the word of the Lord. To God we give the glory and the praise. Will you bow with me, please? Heavenly Father, you're so awesome. And we thank you for loving us, and even while we were yet sinners. Oh, you sent your Son, and he became our substitute on a tree. Bore our sins in his body, paid our debt with his life. Was buried and Sunday morning rose for our justification. It's in the name of Jesus, Father, we ask again that your will be done. That you speak to us again tonight here at Shiloh. And help us to have hearts and minds that will hear you and receive your message. Thank you, Father, for making your presence known. Thank you for the filling of your Holy Ghost, which I know I need, because I cannot preach unless I'm under your control. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for the word that you will preach through me. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
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 And amen.
Amen.
Last night, the Lord spoke to us about freedom.
Freedom.
Before service.
Yes, sir.
Tonight, he wants to talk to us about fitness for service. Fitness for service. Amen. Look at your neighbor. It's a neighbor.
Tonight's message
is about fitness
for
service.
Amen.
Amen. Glad to see, amen, the other twin tonight, little Walter and his wife. Amen. 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 Fitness for service. I said last night, and I say again, that God doesn't need anything from us. He desires. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. But he will not accept any kind of service. Anybody praying with me? And the problem in some churches is that there are people who call themselves serving and they're not fit to serve. You know, cousin, if I don't watch myself, if I get off track, y'all don't hear me. I can get myself in a position where I'm not fit to serve. Then there's some who think that you can fool God as if he is blind and he can't see, he doesn't recognize, but you're just only fooling yourself. And whatever you're doing, it is not acceptable. Somebody talk to me. It's not acceptable unto God. Anything that we do in the flesh, come on somebody, anything that's motivated by our selfish desires and ambition is not accepted by God. There are some who think, amen, I can sin, come on, and operate in sin and still do the work of God and think that God is pleased. No, what you're doing is a stink in the nostrils of God. Anybody praying with me? Can I get a witness? Amen, amen. So this message is important tonight. I want to be fit. Come on, somebody. I want to be fit for serving. Because I really want to serve God. God, as I said last night, God is good. As I said tonight, God is awesome. Come on, somebody. There's nobody like him. Nobody like him. Come on, somebody. Tell me who woke you up this morning. And don't tell me you woke yourself up because you didn't do it. Come on, somebody. And then when you woke up, who clothed you in your right mind? Don't you know there's sometimes you can wake up in the morning, you can wake up crazy and not even know where you are, not even recognize who you are. Come on, somebody. Then gives you a reasonable portion of your health and strength. And as I said before, love you so much, even though we were not worthy, but he would give us his best. Amen, 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 amen. He loved us so much that he became Paul.
Y'all don't get it.
So that we could be rich. So I want to serve him and I want to be fit. Come on, somebody. To serve him. Amen, amen, amen. Now, I also can recognize I can allow devastating things also to get in my way. Come on, somebody. So I hear the prophet. After all the woes he had issued, after all the things he had said, woe to them, woe to them. Read it. He said, in the year that King Uzziah died, and I like this, he said, I saw. I just want to stop right there. I saw. Come on, somebody. Amen. My eyes was open to something. Come on, somebody, that I had taken for granted, or something that I had not recognized, or I should have recognized. He said, I saw. Uzziah, amen, had been king of Jerusalem for about 52 years. Are y'all praying with me? And during that time, amen, the Bible says he was marvelously helped until he was strong. And the thing was, when he became strong, in his own eyes, his heart got lifted up in pride. He tried to do something that he was not qualified to do. Come on, somebody. And when they told him about himself, he had an attitude. Oh, y'all don't hear me. And the Bible lets us know what happened. Because his heart was lifted up, it led to his destruction, and he died a leper. I don't hear y'all. A king. And you know when you have the disease of leprosy, you cut off. Come on, somebody. You cut off. And don't you know that's what sin does? It cuts you off. What separates us from God? It is our sin. Yeah. I can imagine. Because, you know, God had did some great things to us. And now that he was a leper and passed away, I'm pretty sure that was a mournful time for many, because their king, little king, had died. Can I get a witness? Like some were crying because Barack Obama had to get out of office. I didn't cry. Can I get a witness?
Yes, sir.
Perhaps cried even more when Donald Trump became president. I didn't cry.
Yes, sir.
Amen, because amen. Donald Trump nor Barack Obama is my king. My king is still in charge. Can I get a witness? And so, what I like about this, in this time of this mournful time where Uzziah died, amen, Isaiah gets this vision. Can I get a witness? And he gets this vision of the triune God. Can I get a witness? Amen. Represented by the cries of the seraphim.
Come on, somebody.
They didn't just say holy one time, they said it three times. Holy, holy, holy. Can I get a witness? Amen. And then what a change, amen. Amen for Isaiah, because he had a vision of a defeated king, leprous king, amen, in contrast to a one that he sees now that is exalted on the throne, the eternal God. Come on, somebody. And when I learn from this, amen, we're going to go through times of mournfulness and grief and even shame. But what I discover is, during those times, God can give us a revelation that will change us, that will give us hope, that will give us renewed energy and encouragement. Come on, somebody, and I can say that because I know from my own personal experience. Come on, somebody. There were times I've gone through things, but God even allowed me a fresh revelation and a change. Come on, somebody, pick me up. Come on, somebody. Amen. Got me on track. for service. Let's look at this vision. It was a glorious vision. And in time I come across that word glory, I'm reminded of what my professor taught us, amen, in Beeson Divinity School on the campus of Sanford University. He said, glory. When it talks about glory, he said, you know, it. He think about the terminology that the hippies used to use. And they came across something that was profound.
Yeah.
Whether they were stoned or not, and something was profound, they would say, that's heavy, man. He said, that's what the glory of God is. It's the heaviness. Come on, somebody. Amen. And so the vision was a heavy. Heavy vision. He said, in the year King Uzziah died, he said, I also, come on, somebody, saw the Lord sitting upon a throne. And he was high and he was lifted up. Come on, he talked about how, amen, about his glory. Come on, somebody, and look at this. Amen. He had seen the downfall of Uzziah, but he saw the glory of a God who will never fail. Y'all don't hear me. Anybody thankful tonight that we have a God who will never, even when it seems like he's failing, he never fails. Can I get a witness? This vision, amen. It was the reality of, amen, of what the high priest in type experienced when they passed through the veil to get to the holy of holies. It was a symbol, the Lord enthroned and his glory filling the house. Filling the temple. Yeah. I come to tell you, God's throne has always been there. Yeah. Oh, y'all don't hear me. It didn't just show up, amen, when Uzziah saw the vision. Oh, y'all, I mean, when Isaiah saw the vision, the throne of God has always been. Come on, somebody. And the only way we get to see it, he had to remove, amen, the mist of the veil from our eyes. Y'all don't hear me up in here. And when he removed the veil from our eyes, we're able to see God. Amen. Enthroned, exalted, and lifted up. The Bible says only the pure in heart shall see God. Look, if you're going to be fit for service, you've got to see, G. I don't hear y'all up in here. You got to see. You got to see God. You got to see him as he is. Can I get a witness? High and lifted up, he's holy. Come on, somebody. Not 99.9%. He's 100% holy. Anybody praying with me? Can I get a witness? Yeah, he's holy. He's holy. And not only is he holy, how many of y'all know? Amen. He's all wise. Come on, somebody. Amen. Our wisdom would never compare to the wisdom of God. Come on, somebody. The Bible declares, Isaiah said it in chapter 55. God said, declare, my thoughts are higher than your thoughts. My ways are higher than your ways. Come on, somebody. Not only that, but he's omnipotent. He's all powerful. Come on. And we need to see him. We need to see our powerful God. And when he opens your eyes, come on, somebody. And when you see him, and not only you see him, you begin to look back at some areas of your life where you realize it was nothing but the power of God. I could not. yes, 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 yes. Glory to God. He's powerful. Come on, somebody. And he's powerful enough to reach way down, y'all don't hear me, and get you out of the muck and miry clay. Come on, somebody. When you're drowning, he's able to come and rescue you. He's all powerful. We got to see it. Back in 1983, I got a chance to see the glory.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. I was drowning. Couldn't swim. In the muddy Pearl River. I believe it was the enemy who showed me an image of a newspaper.
All right, right, all right.
23-year-old man drowned. The amazing thing is I couldn't see. And yet all of a sudden there was something brighter than the sun. Slipped and I said, Lord, if you show me your hand again, I won't let go. And he showed me his hand. And he delivered me. We need to see it. I don't hear y'all. Resurrected Lord.
Yes.
Come on, somebody.
Yes.
In his glory. Come on, somebody.
Yes.
Come on, somebody. Because he said the light was brighter.
Yes.
Oh, y'all don't hear me.
Yes.
Than the noonday sun. Come on, somebody. We need to see it.
Yes.
Come on, somebody. We're going to be ready. We're going to be fit for service.
Yes.
We got to see God for who he is. He's all wise. He's all powerful. And he's all knowing. Come on, somebody. He knows us better than we can ever know ourselves. He knows what we think even before we think it. We need to see him. And on the day us I died, he said when he died, Isaiah said, I saw him. I saw him in his glory. Tell you something, when you see him, something gonna happen. When you see him, amen. Something happened to Isaiah when he saw. Then notice he said, I also saw the Lord. Something happened when he saw him. Amen, amen. Look at his confession. He said, then say I.
Yeah.
After I saw the Lord, come on, his splendor, come on, somebody, in his glory, I, amen, said, woe is me. Come on, somebody, I'm in trouble. And he said, I'm undone, literally meaning I'm cut off. Oh, y'all don't hear me. I'm cut off, I'm cut off. I tried to
said? He said, I'm undone. I'm cut off. Because I'm a man of unclean lips. Glory to God. One thing I know, when you see the Lord, you'll see yourself. I don't hear y'all because of his light, you're able to see the light. Come on, somebody. A whole lot clearer. Can I get a witness? I don't see Isaiah, amen, wrapped up in pride. I see a man now, amen, who is humble. Can I get a witness? And that's what the holiness of God will do. It will humble us. Come on, somebody, in his sight. He said, unclean lips. How many of y'all know? Unclean lips are only the weapons of a dirty heart. Hey, come on, I don't hear y'all up in here. That's why your lips are dirty, because your heart is dirty. Amen. Your lips speaks what's in your heart. Out of the abundance of the heart. Come on. Y'all help me in this place. The mouth speaks. Yeah, even though Job was an upright man that God, amen, described to Satan, man who shunned him. Yet there were situations where Job just didn't understand. Can I get a witness? But when he saw the law, he, amen, he didn't like himself. Can I get a witness? I remember Peter. Amen. When Jesus, amen, used Peter's boat, amen, to preach and teach. And after preaching and teaching, he told Peter, amen, I want you to go ahead, amen, and I want you to go ahead on out there and launch out there into the deep for a catch. Oh, y'all don't hear me. And I believe Peter, amen, had the wrong attitude, because, amen, he was a professional fisherman. Yeah. Can I get a witness? And if anybody knew anything about fishing, amen, Peter, amen, he thought he knew something about fishing, but he didn't realize he was talking to the one who made the fish. Yeah. Oh, y'all don't hear me. Come on, somebody. Amen. But he said, we've been tolling all. Come on, somebody, we didn't catch nothing. But nevertheless, come on, somebody. Amen. At your word. Amen. I'm going to do it. And so he dropped his net. Oh, glory to God. Can I get a witness? There's so many fish. Y'all don't hear me. He had to beckon for his partners to come help him. Come on, somebody. Amen. So they wouldn't lose that big catch. A fish, and when that took place, amen, Peter, he said to the Lord, amen, depart from me, because I'm a sinful man. He said it because he recognized, amen, who Jesus was. When we see him, we can't help but to see ourselves. It's a time of self-discovery. We're too busy pointing our fingers at other folk. So and so ain't right. I don't even know why they show up to the church. It ain't doing them no good. And fail to look at yourself. And can't recognize the mess that you are in. Glory to God. But when you see God, you'll see yourself. Get ready, because when you see yourself, he'll show you some stuff about yourself that's not pretty. Can I get a witness? And when you see, amen, yourself in the things that's not pretty, amen, you'll get ashamed of being in that condition. Y'all don't hear me? Have that ever happened to you, amen, when you saw how stupid you were? Come on, somebody. You see how silly you act? Come on, somebody. And you just got through shouting on Sunday. Come on, somebody. Just because somebody stepped on your toe, you cussing them out now. Amen, amen. Y'all, I don't hear y'all up in here. Have you ever, amen, seen yourself looking stupid? I remember my wife and I, we were having, amen, a tense moment of fellowship. We were arguing. I don't hear y'all up in here. Some of y'all act like y'all don't have tense moments of fellowship. And it was tense. It was so tense that both of us said if we had divorce papers, we both would sign them right now. And we're Christian. Come on, somebody. We're Christian. We're Christian. And the Lord let me see not only him, but he let me see myself. And the Spirit just said, just look at you. Oh, y'all just don't know how that broke my heart. Come on, somebody. Parents, you ever did that to your children? They messed up, and you just said, just look at yourself. Just look at yourself. And you don't even want to hear the crying. Come on, just hush up. Just hush up. Come on, somebody. Amen, amen, amen. You're ashamed to look at yourself. Come on, somebody. Yeah. But when you see yourself, and then when you, amen, don't like what you see, a change ought to be following. You ought not want to stay in that same condition. Come on, somebody. You ought not want to keep up that same attitude. You ought not want to keep that same habit going. Come on, somebody. Amen, because it's a shame. I'm trying to hit her up here. When we look to Calvary, it ought to convict us. Because Christ was there not for himself. He hadn't done nothing. Come on, somebody. But he was there because of you and me. And every sin was laid on him. And you know, God, because he's holy, when he looked at himself, come on, somebody, he could even look at himself. And Jesus said, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Amen, because he then made sin for you and for me. Come on, somebody, and the Father couldn't look on the Son because he became sin. Come on, somebody. And so the first thing, when we look to Calvary, it ought to convict us, but then it ought to turn around and give us hope, because it's at that same place. Y'all don't hear me. It's at that same place, amen, where my sin was taken care of. It's at that same place where I saw the light. At the same place my battle was rolled. Oh, you know the song. It was at the cross. At the cross. Where I first saw the light, and the burdens of my heart, they rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight. Now I'm happy. the light of the glory of God. Shiloh, I come to tell you tonight that there will be hope for you. Because I believe you have a servant of God who has a clear vision of God. And when you have a pastor that has a clear vision of God, and when he's honest with himself, and whenever there's a need in his own walk with the Lord, when the leader is right, I believe somebody is going to fall right in line. Yeah, in the year King Uzziah died. Yes, Lord, I saw you on the throne. And lifted up your glory, filling the place. And I'm like Isaiah, I thank you, Lord, for showing me yourself. Because when I saw you, I was able to truly see myself. I'm gotta confess, when I saw myself, I wasn't pleased at what I saw. I had to come clean and to confess that I am under. I am cut off because I got unclean lips. Pray God, holy name. How many of you know when you come honest with God in your confession that he will be shortly? Can I get a witness? But as often we try to hide and cover our sin, you know we will not prosper. Praise God tonight. Because Isaiah, amen, was honest in his confession. Look what happened, my brothers. Then flew one of the seraphims unto me. And when he came unto me, Isaiah said, he didn't come empty-handed. And the Lord, he came to me having a life coal in his hand. And the Lord, all right, I believe that this is a figure of the work of the Holy Ghost. And the Lord, all right, taking the work of Jesus and applying it to our hearts. And the Lord, all right, how many of you know you can't be born again apart from the work of the Holy Ghost? And the Lord, all right, and I see the Holy Ghost moving in this vision. And the Lord, all right, he takes a live coal from off the altar of sacrifice. And the Lord, all right, applying that live coal. Can I get a witness to Isaiah? Can I get a witness? Amen. For his trouble and unclean soul. Yes, he said, amen, this coal, it touched his lips. And the Lord, all right, yes, and when it touched his lips, can I get a witness? I heard, amen, the results. He said, your sin was purged, your iniquity was taken away. to forgive us and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. But I'm telling you, not only will you forgive, he'll cleanse. That like gold, not only did it purify, ain't the Lord all right, but it gave power, ain't the Lord all right. How do you know? I'm going to tell you in a minute here. Ain't the Lord all right. Power, not only the purge, power to make you fit for service for the Lord. Can I do a witness? Praise his holy name. I heard God say, who shall I see? Who will go for us? Ain't the Lord all right?
You ought to come.